Okay, so let's talk about lidocaine. Lidocaine brings about negative inotropic effects and antiarrhythmic actions in the heart, which weaken the force of muscular contractions and can calm erratic and uncoordinated electromyocardial activity. Due to lidocaine's antiarrhythmic properties, its primary use is for cardiac arrest from ventricular fibrillation and pulseless ventricular tachycardia. Lidocaine is also effective in treating stable, monomorphic ventricular tachycardia with preserved ventricular function, stable polymorphic ventricular tachycardia with normal baseline, and a QT interval and preserved lower ventricular function when ischemia is treated and electrolyte balance is corrected. It can be used for stable polymorphic VT with baseline and QT interval prolongation when torsades is suspected. Lidocaine shouldn't be used as a prophylactic treatment in acute myocardial infarction. It's suggested that we reduce the maintenance dose in the presence of impaired liver function or lower ventricular dysfunction, and we should discontinue infusion immediately if signs of toxicity develop. Lidocaine would be contraindicated if there's a known hypersensitivity to lidocaine or derivatives like xylocaine, novocaine, etc. But lidocaine is also contraindicated in sinus bradycardia and atrial ventricular blocks. Now, the adult dosage for cardiac arrest from VFib or pulseless VTach is an initial dose of 1 to 1.5 milligrams per kilogram IV or IO. Now remember, lidocaine is one of those drugs that can also be delivered via endotracheal tube. Now for refractory VFib, an additional 0.5 to 0.75 milligrams per kilogram may be given IV push. And this can be repeated in 5 to 10 minutes to a maximum of 3 doses or a total of 3 milligrams per kilogram. For perfusing arrhythmias like stable ventricular tachycardia or a wide complex tachycardia or uncertain type or significant ectopy, doses range from 0.5 to 0.75 milligrams per kilogram and up to 1 to 1.5 milligrams per kilogram. This too can be repeated at 0.5 to 0.75 milligrams per kilogram every 5 to 10 minutes to that maximum dose of 3 milligrams per kilogram. Now, for a maintenance infusion, give 1 to 4 milligrams per minute, which is equal to 30 to 50 micrograms per kilogram per minute. Remember that a micro drip infusion set is needed in order to deliver the appropriate dose. A common but simple calculation for mixing a lidocaine drip is this: the IV bag amount in milliliters times the dose ordered, usually milligrams per minute, times the drip set, which is drops per milliliter, divided by the drug on hand in milligrams. This should equal your correct drops per minute.